Hi, I'm Jon Bon Jovi, and you've got your TV turned on to turn up the volume.
It's showtime!
Turn up the volume. Do it this way.
Hi, I'm Klaus Meiner of the Scorpions, and you're watching Turn Up the Volume. Yeah.
Hello, this is PJ Farley.
And Peter Lawrence
from Trickster. And don't forget to catch our live story on Rising Stars.
Right here. Turn up the volume.
So turn up the volume, you rule.
Awesome.
Is this Winger?
Now it's clear that you need to do something to check that you're going to be recording.
Oh, I have to.
Absolutely.
It's more important to me to entertain those kids and the people that
definitely
come to see me.
That's what
Well, I always wanted to be in a rock and roll band, you know? I mean, every kid's dreams to be in a rock and roll band.
Let's get this one on film. I was not White Toast tonight.
No.
Right?
White Toast.
Right?
Anybody.
I just wanted to be known that I, for the first time,
he went one, and we were like, push, and you went tush.
Well, for the guys that missed the show, sorry. We'll see you next time. For the guys that were here, we kicked your ass. And, you know, we'll see you again real soon. Thank you. It's real good to be here in Italy.
E dice, per tutti quelli che sono riusciti a prendere il biglietto, beh, sapete cosa vi aspetta, e we're gonna kick ass.
We're up in Montreal, Canada with Jon Bon Jovi.
Hi, John.
Hey, Sharon.
Oh, we are here. He is producing the new Aldo Nova record up at Lake Studio. Do you remember what it was in the beginning that actually got you off the ground? What?
Runaway. I wrote Runaway in 82, and I didn't have a band. You know, I didn't have anything going. But a radio DJ in New York started playing it, and one station snowballed into 20. And that led the record companies to be forced to take interest, you know? And so I put the band together, which was supposed to have been for 3 weeks. It's now been, what, 7 years? Still the same guys, you know?
I mean, with the underground and all that, you have Aldo, you have the Skids, you have Billy Falcon. What do you look for when you get tapes in?
Great songs, really. I mean, it's not like I'm a record executive or wanting to be a businessman. It's just the opportunity came up when Cinderella came to the label, Polygram went, oh boy, wasn't he lucky, isn't that great? And when Polygram passed on Skid Row and Atlantic took him and then they sold so well, they went, geez, he was lucky again. And then they heard Aldo and they went, you know, and then they decided to make the underground a real label. Then they heard Billy and they ran over here and said, quick, get in the studio. So Bon Jovi's now on the underground and Richie's first album's on the underground. So, you know, it's really turning into something, but all it was meant to be a label for kids run by kids, more or less. You know what I mean? My attitude was that, look, I can help you out because A&R guys are afraid or they don't hear it or whatever. And I figure they can't fire me from my own label. So if I like something, great, go ahead, have a good time, go in the studio, make a record. That's all it is. You know, it really shouldn't be misconstrued, I guess, is the word.
That's the word.
Misconstrued. You know, as John's sitting behind the desk, I'm going to get out on stage every night and still do my thing. But in a year like this, when we're not touring, don't expect me to become a gardener. It's not, you know, just these hands just don't do it.
That's right.
But I know how to make records. This record is an important one to us, you know. I mean, it'll be my sixth album already. I just need to step back for a minute, regroup, get a new direction, you know. I mean, how many times have you heard people, you know, say, oh, this sounds like, and, you know, I don't want to have people continually getting compared, you know, oh, it sounds like a Bon Jovi song. Well, Bon Jovi needs to go and create a new sound now.
Back on the whole career the past 7-8 years, I mean, when you've just actually been in the real limelight, what comes to your head the most? What memory hits you the most? I'm thinking Giant Stadium.
It's one of them. I mean, that was a hell of a day. I don't know. I mean, you just said it. I don't know, at this moment, you know. I don't know. I mean, I remember getting my first gold record. That was 5 years ago now. Or going to Japan for the first time, going to Russia to set that whole thing up in the middle of winter 2 years ago. I don't know. I mean, I remember going in the studio the first day to start our first album. So I remember all kinds of little goofy things.
I was just thinking of what this all actually means to you, but I'm thinking probably the best angle to take from that is when you're live and you're on stage and you're in front of all those kids. What does it all mean to you then? What sort of feelings running through you?
It's hard to explain to somebody who isn't actually in the shoes of the guy singing out there, you know, actually doing it. Because to think that, you know, there's 10 or 20,000 sets of eyes looking at you and you say hi and they say hi, you go, wow. It works, you know? The microphone's on, you know? It's a higher high than I think you could ever get from drugs or booze. I'd love to say that it's better than sex, but sometimes it sure as hell is, and it's something that you wouldn't take any money for. You'd pay people to come. You know, there's nothing like it. When I'm out there, I'm real grateful to be a part of that.
Looking back at Young Guns, were you surprised? I mean, you ended up turning out to be a household name out of that. All over the place, your name was everywhere. Surprised how that turned out?
I don't know. You know, people have been asking me that lately. I think, I don't know how surprised I was. I'm pleased. But I thought that it was good, or I wouldn't have put it out. You know, I was pleased with the acceptance that it's received. But as far as, you know, surprise, I really wasn't, because I wouldn't have put it out. I would have just said, this isn't good enough. You know, it doesn't represent me or this movie. But I am real pleased that the folks liked it.
So your videos rode so high on that. Blaze of Glory was up there for a long time.
Yeah, that was really neat. They did it. Wayne Isham did a great job.
As usual.
He really is good. He did a good one on that.
One thing that the kids can at least deal with next year is a home video.
Yeah, that's fun. It's Tales of the Road, more or less, you know? I mean, it was, I think they called it Access All Areas, which is funny because I set out to document the Jersey tour. And I had the idea while we were recording the album, but nobody listened, as usual. And we didn't roll any film. I was really sorry that I didn't, you know, follow my instincts and do it, but from like the third or fourth show on the tour through the end of the tour, we filmed. I hope that I just continue to produce for 91 and get a Bon Jovi record out for, like, say, January 92.
So what do you suggest to all the kids in the world? What are they going to do for a whole year without you?
I think they'll do okay.
At least answer that for me.
Just don't forget us. Yeah, just don't forget us. We're around. We're doing other things, that's all.